stars. Early adopter, Nest to Lyric, updated review. This thermostat is the first real contender in the Nest market niche. It's a Wi-Fi enabled thermostat with some interesting techie level features, but not without its own flaws. In this review I'm posting my comparison of the new Lyric to my old Gen 1 Nest. Backplate installation comparison between Nest and Lyric. Lyric installation is a bit easier than Nest, where the Lyric the cover plate and junction block are screwed onto the wall as one piece with two screws. The Lyric install however feels wobblier and flimsier than the Nest installation, where a metal backplate is mounted on the wall first, then the junction block and front plate bolts onto the metal backplate. Wiring installation comparison between Nest and Lyric. Lyric is just as easy as Nest, however it appears much better able to deal with oddball wiring than Nest, evident from the Lyric's terminals block. I've also read in the support forums that it allows for direct control of Honeywell humidifiers and external sensors, but I haven't confirmed it myself. Lyric definitely shows Honeywell's legacy in thermostat design here. They know what sort of systems are out there from very long-term experience. Initial configuration. Lyric versus Nest. Lyric is much easier than Nest. With Nest, you need to enter its initial settings with the jog wheel. I.e., entering the SSID for Wi-Fi can take a while when entering it one character at a time. Lyric on the other hand boots up and becomes its own Wi-Fi access point for 3 minutes. Then, using the Lyric app, and your iOS device connects directly to the Lyric, not via your router/access point, and all configuration happens from the iOS device, iPhone, iPad, etc., with the iOS device as the user interface to key settings in. Device user interface comparison. Lyric versus Nest. The Lyric's display and user interface does seem to be a step ahead of Nest. You can look at the weather forecast, turn the device on and off, switch between AC and heat, or set the system to away without having to drill down any menus. App user interface comparison. Lyric versus Nest. Nest easily beats out Lyric. The Lyric user application interface is new and has its quirks. For example, when loading the app and clicking on the thermostat, clicking on the temperature readout that comes up for the thermostat shuts off the HVAC system. Be careful not to double-click on the display. Also, I haven't been able to explore the geofencing options. The Lyric UI doesn't seem to be very intuitive, yet. Lyric's UI is definitely generation 1. Nest clearly beats the Lyric out here, no contest. Temperature control/operation. Lyric versus Nest, the Lyric simply blows away the Nest here. The Nest seems to allow too much variation and fluctuation, wobble, in temperature in favor of squeezing a bit more energy savings. Temperature control is Lyric's game, period. After one day, our home felt far more comfortable. With the Nest, there were days where I set the AC thermostat to 72. But the home felt like 75. To force the system on, I had to turn it down to 70 just to force the AC come on. The Lyric has some tricks in its bag, such as monitoring a combination of temperature and humidity to make the air more comfortable. The Lyric is not perfect. Here is what's not right as of my writing this review, no instructions/manual. Some of the functions are vague and the only way to figure out what they do is to search the Lyric community forums for answers. The system does come with guided install using the application, and they have several videos available. I'm still an old school techie, Just tell me where the buttons are and what they do. No Kindle app. This needs to be fixed quickly, Imo. Kindles make up a large segment of the Android devices out there. We've got more Kindles in our home than iPhone/iPads and I'm hoping they make a Kindle app available via the Amazon App Store soon. No web interface. Nest allows you to log in and change settings using a standard web interface, for PCs and other devices. At the time of this writing, I haven't seen an analog to this with Lyric. Some functions appear broken in the app, i.e., setting the sleep backlight to anything other than 0% just reverts back to 0 in a few seconds. Other interesting tidbits, Nest uses an onboard rechargeable lithium battery for system backup. The Lyric has a user-changeable AAA. They included one Energizer lithium AAA in mine. I like having a user-changeable backup battery. My Nest seemed to have a never-ending slew of Wi-Fi connection problems. After trying almost a dozen different access points as well as a replacement Nest, the Nest dropping out and not being accessible became a way of life that myself and some other Nest users have just put up with. The Lyric seems rock solid in terms of connectivity and isn't as finicky as the Nest with Wi-Fi access points. All in all, having owned both the Lyric and Nest, I'm glad I changed over to Lyric. For a Gen 1 product, it does what it's supposed to very well. Also, considering all other Wi-Fi enabled smart thermostats, Nest finally has a real competitor in the Lyric, which is good for everyone. Update. I raised my review from 4 to 5 stars. I'm still a little annoyed by the absence of a Kindle app for the Lyric, but it's just done a fantastic job in temperature control since I've installed it. The house just feels amazingly comfortable. This Lyric seems to be constantly one step ahead in terms of external temperature fluctuations and humidity. Also, the system has been running for about a week and it has had zero connection problems. I've also had the chance to use the Quick Away functionality and it's worked very well. Finally, we had a nasty storm come through yesterday where we lost power about a dozen times within an hour. The Lyric came through without any problems. Update. Thanks for everyone's comments and follow UPS on my review. One of the more common questions I saw was on the C-wire. I double-checked, and my system definitely does not have a C-wire. This all got me thinking on how far I'll get on the lithium AAA that was included, so I conducted a small test. I took a pair of brand new Enelib Pro AAA low self-discharge batteries, 900 mAh. I recharged them both, twice, to make sure they were full. I installed one in the Lyric, and stored the other at room temperature. I let the Lyric operate for about 6 hours. Then I pulled the battery from the Lyric, and charged both of them again, on my Maha Wizard UN charger. The battery used by the Lyric showed a 1-2 mAh drop after 6 hours. The unused battery showed a 8 mAh self-discharge drop, control, after 6 hours. The difference is 4 mAh, so that's what the Lyric pulled in 6 hours, or 1/6 mAh in 24 hours, in my single trial test. Based on my calculations, the Energizer Lithium AAA packs 1200 mAh fresh out of the pack, so this translates to 75 days of operation at my estimated drain rates. I'm not sure what happens when the internal cell goes cold, and if the Lyric has an NVRAM strategy for keeping things going without significant disruption. I'll try to post an update when this happens. 2.0 out of 5 stars. A source of frustration. Update. continually frustrated by the lyric. The geofencing is just a joke. It appears that it won't recognize when someone is home, only when they cross the geofence threshold. For instance, if you are on the phone at the moment you cross the geofence boundary, the signal never gets sent to the lyric to activate your home/away settings. Perhaps this is only an issue for Verizon customers, since they can't get simultaneous voice/data, at least not in all markets with all devices. My wife came home to a cold house today because she was on the phone when she crossed the geofence boundary, and the app/system isn't smart enough to know her phone is now connected to the same Wi-Fi network as the lyric. It has no idea that she's home. The lyric is still in away mode. On a positive note, the notifications now seem to work very well. The fact that I didn't get one when she was on the way home or got home was a clear indicator that the lyric has no clue that the house is occupied. One other issue I managed to solve, though it shouldn't be this hard, my wife's phone got switched to small geofences somehow. Even though I switched it off, the lyric continued to trigger on the 500 feet radius. I had to delete the home and away shortcuts and recreate them. They do not update themselves when changing geofence radius. Still, after all this time on the market, the app still can't tell you if the system is running. Is it actively cooling? Heating? Ventilating? Circulating? Humidifying? No way to tell. How is this still not available? All in all, the lyric continues to be a source of frustration for me. So much potential with such poor execution. I'm all but certain the humidifier control will fail to do its job this winter. If so, that will be the final nail in the coffin, and the lyric will come off the wall. Hopefully the Echobee 3 is a winner, or the Nest gets a few more fine control features. Original review, I think the lyric has potential, but it needs a lot of work. First of all, the big feature they advertise, geofencing, does not work. It doesn't activate. Neither do the supposed notifications. Also, even if it did work, there are only two geofence radii to choose from, 500 feet and 7 miles. Why on earth they don't just allow users to select their own geofence distance is beyond me. There is no manual, either in the box or online. Your only source of information is in the app, and that is only half-baked. When configuring the lyric through the app, there are some vague settings. You can click the More Information button in the app, but these More Information screens are all blank. They literally have no text or diagrams. I am assuming they are supposed to be pulling information from the web, but since during this part of the setup your phone is connected to the lyric via Wi-Fi, you are not connected to the web. With such advanced settings and capabilities, it would be nice to know if they were set correctly/optimally. Also, there is no way to set priorities over the automatic functions. For instance, let's say the geofencing did work. If you have a program set to lower the temperature at night, this function would still take over even if you were away for the weekend. So, the savings you might have had from the lyric automatically adjusting your temperature while you were away will be overridden by the evening program. There is no way to tell the lyric to use the away setting as priority over the night program. One big beef I have, being an early adopter of the lyric, is that there is already a newer version. The version shown in the app diagrams is the newer version. I, and at least a few others leaving reviews here, received the first version. While there are definite improvements to the new version mounting plate, Honeywell refuses to answer whether there is any difference in the actual thermostat hardware. The mounting plate for version 1 doesn't hold the Lyric well. If you push the weather button on the unit, it falls off the wall. I have no way of knowing if the newer mounting plate fixes this issue. I do know the newer mounting plate has a different terminal block layout and a gasket to keep wall drafts from interfering with temperature and humidity readings. Mine also came with a dead battery. The Lyric should be able to run the fan for a few seconds after the heat or A/C has shut off. This ensures that all the hot or cold air your system has generated is pushed into your living space, not left sitting in the ductwork. Alas, the Lyric is not capable of such a simple task. From the app, there is no way to tell what the current state of your system or home environment is, other than the current and set point temperature. There is no way to see what the current humidity level is, or whether your humidifier is running. There is no way to tell if your furnace, blower, or A/C is currently running, let alone whether it is in first or second stage. There is also no reporting of daily/weekly/hourly/monthly, any time period, run times. As for the positives, and there actually are some, the Lyric seems to do a great job of keeping the inside environment comfortable. Temperature and humidity are both kept at more comfortable levels than they were with our old thermostat. This may be due to the Lyric's advertised ability to use weather forecasts to predict needs and get ahead of changing weather. I also like the ability to have the fan circulate the air in the home even without a call for heat/cool. This helps balance the temperature throughout various rooms and floors of the house. I ended up passing on the Nest for a few reasons, which I hope the Lyric solves first. Nest uses motion sensing to know whether someone is home. Our thermostat is mounted in a little used room, so that feature would be a problem. The Lyric does not have this feature/issue. Second, the Nest allows large temperature swings before calling for heat or cool. If I set my thermostat for 70 degrees, I want my house to be 70 degrees, not constantly swinging between 67 and 73. The Lyric has a 1 degree trigger, as do all Honeywell thermostats. I think it would be nice if both Nest and Lyric offered their users the ability to set these constraints, but neither of them do. Third, the Nest only has the most basic humidifier controls. Set a RH%, and it will attempt to hold it. I don't believe the Nest can run the humidifier and furnace blower without a call for heat, however. The Lyric apparently has much more advanced controls, not only being able to run the blower and humidifier even in the absence of a heat call, thereby allowing the humidifier to run as long as necessary to achieve the desired RH%, but taking into account the outside temperature to adjust the RH% setting on the fly to avoid frost/condensation on the inside of windows. Of course, I have no way to test whether this works as advertised until winter. To sum it up, if they can fix the bugs and missing features, Lyric has some big potential. For now, the price is too high for a unit with so many issues. 1.0 out of 5 stars. Do not buy from Amazon, this is not an authorized retailer. So I purchased two Lyrics to operate my separate downstairs and upstairs AC units. Within a week, one was giving me problems, where it would say charging with a half full green bar. Then the other started acting up. Then both went offline. I changed the batteries multiple times, restarted and reinstalled the units, and switched my circuit breaker, to no avail. I installed these myself, and placed multiple calls were placed to Honeywell's Lyric helpline thinking I'd installed them incorrectly. Honeywell told me that both units were defective, and I could return the units through their warranty process, which could take up to 10 days to get new units. Not happening as I needed to cool my house ASAP with a baby sleeping upstairs. So they suggested that I buy new units at Lowe's, which they said was the only authorized retail seller. This made me very curious, and when I point blank asked if Amazon.com was an authorized retailer, they said no. So I rushed out and bought two new units at my nearest Lowe's. Notably, the units from Lowe's are very different from these units. The back plate is completely different, with a vertical wiring system as opposed to horizontal. I noted this during the installation process, as the picture used in Honeywell's own app was different from these units, but I thought it was the app that was dated, not my Lyric. Also, the units from Lowe's are much more responsive to touch, both light up on approach better than these units, and the lighting is just brighter and different than these units. My only conclusion is that the units being sold here on Amazon are older, beta testing units. Honeywell appears to have changed a lot about these units before they were ready for mass retail at the big box hardware stores, and someone is dumping the old beta units on the public, which in my case did not work. Given my experience, I would not buy from Amazon and would only buy from Lowe's. Sending both of these back and asking for a full RAS. Early adopter, Nest to Lyric, updated review. This thermostat is the first real contender in the Nest market niche. It's a Wi-Fi enabled thermostat with some interesting techie level features, but not without its own flaws. In this review I'm posting my comparison of the new Lyric to my old Gen 1 Nest. Backplate installation comparison between Nest and Lyric. Lyric installation is a bit easier than Nest, where the Lyric the cover plate and junction block are screwed onto the wall as one piece with two screws. The Lyric install however feels wobblier and flimsier than the Nest installation, where a metal backplate is mounted on the wall first, then the junction block and front plate bolts onto the metal backplate. Wiring installation comparison between Nest and Lyric. Lyric is just as easy as Nest, however it appears much better able to deal with oddball wiring than Nest, evident from the Lyric's terminals block. I've also read in the support forums that it allows for direct control of Honeywell humidifiers and external sensors, but I haven't confirmed it myself. Lyric definitely shows Honeywell's legacy in thermostat design here. They know what sort of systems are out there from very long-term experience. Initial configuration. Lyric versus Nest. Lyric is much easier than Nest. With Nest, you need to enter its initial settings with the jog wheel. I.e., entering the SSID for Wi-Fi can take a while when entering it one character at a time. Lyric on the other hand boots up and becomes its own Wi-Fi access point for 3 minutes. Then, using the Lyric app, and your iOS device connects directly to the Lyric, not via your router/access point, and all configuration happens from the iOS.